what your dough is supposed to look like. Smooth and elastic. It should make should be like a window pane where you can barely see through it. If you mix it too much, it's going to expand and it's going to split when you steam it. Measure the dough. Make them into about the size of your palm. If you're a guy, make it smaller than your palm. Roll it out to about an inch in thickness. Echo case. They sell this already made for you. But if you want to be a high achiever, you can boil your beans, add the sugar, and mix it up. But it's so much simpler to get it in the pack. And you can eat it out of the pack right away. Paper. Whatever they tell you, you can put it in a steamer without paper. They're lying. Put parchment paper down. Because it will stick to everything. Because you see how my dough gets on my paper right away? It's going to expand when you put it in your steamer. These turned out to be bigger than my parchment. So it's best if you steam them one to two at a time, because I have one that ended up that big. Yes. Wax paper. Parchment or wax paper would be fine. See how big they got? They're not even on the paper anymore. And I made four out of them. Five out of them? Yeah. My steamer's small. So you heat these for about 6 minutes. Then you can remove them and spray them with food coloring. I don't have a pastry spray paint for that, so I hand painted all of them. You just dilute the food coloring just a little bit and you can brush them off. Okay. And that's what it looks like on the inside. I use egg roll paste, the red bean paste. So it's all light and fluffy. It's almost the texture of a very dense tweet. Alright, what's this? This is my dangle sandwich! Yes. Feel. All of you, feel. Alright. This is what you will need. All of this is available in supermarkets at H Target. As much as well, I've seen it in Walmart and Target. So you can get that. Cook them in cold water right away so they firm up. then you can serve them with sugar, strawberry jelly, raspberry jelly, chocolate, honey, whatever. Because they're not sweet. They're not sweet at all. That's what the added sides are. Matcha is really good with these too. They're kind of bland. These are your Asian markets, people! There's some in Lincoln and there are some in Omaha. Find them! These are the cooking aids that I use when I cook. Guy and Honey, Cooking with Dog, Japanese Cooking 101, and Ochikiro. I love her. She makes it so simple. Honey is funny. He will take anything that you request, and he will put a Japanese twist on it. These are food staples that people need. This is bonito flakes. This you put in stocks and soups and cooking in general. It is the most important thing in your pantry when it comes to Japanese cooking. That and kombu. Kombu, you put in your water to boil things. It gives it kind of seafood flavor, kind of like you would put old bay spice in your crabs to boil them. It's the same concept. Banana shoga, pickled ginger. It is red, and it comes in a container like this. Can anybody tell me what this is? Just throw candy all over that side. Whoever gets it gets it. Alright, this is Japanese mayonnaise. It is $6. It is amazing.
Does anybody have any questions? Thank you.